price. Buy your collection at Walmart stores and walmart.com.
Hi, I'm Robert Osborne. Up next in our night with Robert Mitchum, we have a movie Mitchum made in the first decade of his film career when he was under contract to Howard Hughes, who owned RKO Radio Pictures at that time. The movie is a crime drama from 1951 titled The Racket. It was made at a point in Mitchum's career when he was still considered the bad boy of Hollywood because of a 1948 arrest for possession of marijuana, the fact he'd been locked up in a jail for a couple of months because of it. At the time he was arrested, you know, Mitchum had said, "This is the end of everything for me." He said, "It's the end of my career, my home, my marriage." But it clearly wasn't. Mitchum came out of jail a more popular star than he'd ever been. Maybe because his screen image had always been that of a bad boy, and one sort of expected Mitchum might be spending his nights doing things the law said he shouldn't be doing. Nor did it end his marriage, I must say. Wife Dorothy Mitchum stayed Bob's wife for 57 years, until his death in 1997. But it was because of Mitchum's soiled reputation that Howard Hughes began having Mitchum cast at RKO as the good guy, the misunderstood man, hoping that that would eventually clean up his public image. And this next movie, The Racket, was part of that new image campaign. It's a story that had first been done as a stage play back in the 1920s, starring Edward G. Robinson. After that, it had been done as a silent movie produced by Howard Hughes, who updated it for this Mitchum version in 1951. His co-stars are Robert Ryan and, on loan out from producer Hal Wallace at Paramount Studios, Elizabeth Scott. There's also Robert Hutton and the scene-stealing Iris Adrian. So, from 1951, directed by John Cromwell, The Racket.